What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Let's get me out of the picture. We are here in Amarillo, Texas, and we're getting a greasing done. They've already gone down below. I'll show you really quick. Okay, you have fittings down here. Okay, there's fittings over here, over there. But we also have some fittings that are right here that have to get greased, along with there's a fitting right over here, and should be one right over there. Whoop, almost lost you there. So they did the other side too already, but they still have to do the upside here. You got this over here. There's also one over on this side over there, right over here somewhere. And down over here, you have fitting, can't really see it, but you have to do grease over there. And here we go over here. So he's getting ready to do the greasing up front there. So we'll see what he's doing. Yeah, he's putting a lot of grease on that one. Hopefully they don't charge extra for that, right? So I wonder how many people are in here. Am I the only person that's here on this live chat? I guess because it's early in the afternoon. Can you hear me okay? We got three people in, so we're getting greased. As you can see there, and right over there, and he's taking care of that over there. I've been to this location before. They do a pretty good job. They get to you pretty quickly. This is in Amarillo, Texas, across from the Flying J, which is the west side. This is on the east side. Now, they're going to have to continue over here. In the back, they're going to have to do some greasing back here. So I'm here to get truck and trailer greased. What's going on, everyone? We have Big Red's here. Johnny, trying to get that Magdalone. Nice truck, thank you. Okay. Looks like they already did it, sorry. They've already greased back here. Okay, so you can see right there and right over there, they've already greased. And over there next to the other wheel, okay, look at the yellow. Next to the yellow, you'll see something a little red over there. So, and it's not a long process. It's pretty quick. So we're not going to keep you guys here too long. And Mike's World, what's going on? Jesse Wyatt, what's going on? We got Ralph Lodo. Good evening. Once they're done here, I'm going to get back on the road. Hopefully you guys can hear me okay. And hello from Michigan. That's from Greg Monholland. We got Zeldo. Now we have those three fittings right there. Okay, he's going inside the back there for more fittings. Okay, we got this over here was done. He's still going to need to do, now it looks like they've already done this side here. Okay, so you see, you got this fitting here, we got this fitting over here. And over there in the front, over there, there's some more. We have to make sure they did it. I don't think they did that one yet. They might have missed that one. I'm trying to look at it. I believe there is one right there. So we've got to make sure he gets that one. I got a question. Sorry. Is there a fitting right over here? Right up in the front? It looks like it's got dirt on it. right down there.
It's gonna be right down there on the
screen. Right, a little bit further down, right. Right, a little bit there. There you go. Yeah, on both sides. It's okay. I'm doing so. It's like I'm pointing out the things that need to be done, and I'm like, well, that one looks like it's a little bit hidden, a little bit harder to see.
Those ones usually are, because they're like right there under all those wires.
Yeah.
A lot of times, if you ain't really looking for them and you ain't paying attention, you're gonna
are you okay with being on live chat? Okay, we've got Dakota.
Yes,
is that your name?
Yes, sir. I'm the crew chief.
We got the crew chief here, guys. That's Dakota. What's going on, Dakota? Thank you very much. Thank you for supervising and overseeing. I actually have good experience here at this one. I did, another chat the last time I was here. It was good because you guys got me out of here pretty quick, and I also saw the problem really fast. So we do appreciate the hard work that you guys put in. Yeah, I was just pointing that out, too. I didn't know if you had seen that.
You missed three more.
He's not doing a bad job. But this is something that you, as the owner operator, or you know, if you're taking your truck in to get serviced, you do want to make sure that you are looking to see where they're greasing, because they could end up, you know, if they did miss something, and it takes maybe another 3 or 4 months before you get it greased again, that might be the difference of something breaking down on you, and then you're gonna have major problems. But I've already watched them do some of the other fittings that were in here, guys. So let's see who else we have here. How is the truck doing with miles per gallon? She's doing pretty good. Hey, what's up? Okay, we got you. We got 16 people in here. Come on, guys, let's get the thumbs up. Just pointing out something here for all you young, new drivers or new owner operators, lease purchase operators, things that you need to check when you're getting your truck and trailer greased. You do want to be there to watch and see what they're doing, because yeah, that's their job. You know, they're supposed to know what they're doing. But if you don't look it over, give a good once over, it is possible that they might skip something, and it might be something that's very, very important. In fact, it's always important. So down over here, we're going to show you guys. Okay, got the over here fitting, and you also have one that's on this side over here. I'm not sure if the camera is angled correctly, if you guys can see it or not, but you definitely want to do the greasing on there too. And let's see what comments we have here. We've got Mike Peridin. What's going on, brother? And BNSF. Okay, hey Mark, I'm here. And Zoldo, so would you recommend CRST to start? I started with CRST, so I would recommend them. But it is up to you to do your thorough, I guess, research on companies and see which one you're comfortable with. But I did very well with them, and so I do. Excuse me, guys. I do give CRST my thumbs up. Not everyone's going to give that. But then not everyone's going to give a thumbs up for Swift, for Schneider, for Prime, any number of trucking companies, mega carriers. You're going to have people that have had bad experiences. Okay, so let's look over here. Okay, some more greasing done over here. Okay, more greasing over here. And then underneath here. Okay, so lots of places where you have to do... You have to put the zert fitting, excuse me, you have to put the greaser onto the zert fittings. So it looks like they've got them all, and they did finally get this one over here. This one is also done. So now all I have to do is pretty much go inside, I think, and wrap it up. Let me just double check. Hey, they're already done?
I was trying to find my guy, make sure he got it.
There was a guy that did go underneath. He already finished underneath.
Yeah, that's what he did.
Yeah, he did that first. Two guys, they were underneath, and then so one was up here and one was back in the back.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure. Did witness work though? Did you witness door?
Did I witness it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I saw them do it. Yeah. They did it first, and then he came in and did his part.
All right.
So but it looks like everything was done. Okay. We're going to close the hood, guys. Wait. Just be careful because I don't want. Just be careful because I don't want to slip and fall in there. Imagine that. No, I don't want to imagine that. Let's not imagine that. Let's not even talk about it. Okay, hold on. Doesn't seem like it's seated prop. I want to make sure it's in there correctly. And we are on. So the only thing I have to do right now is just go inside and pay the bill. But it looks like everything is done. It was just a truck and trailer grease today. And wanted to share it with you, point out certain things to look for. And we did that. So without any further delay, guys, let's flip the camera around. I look really tired. I'm not dead tired. I'm just a little bit exhausted because I have so much to do. I have to continue doing a video, you know, later on today. And so there's a Corvette video. There's also another video with the truck that I've already started working on. I was up late last night working on it, but we're going to be finished. I hope I'm going to finish that video tonight because I really want to start the Corvette video with Sarah. And I think all you guys, when you do see it, you'll see why I worked so hard on it and why it was so important to do. But anyway, everyone, be safe, be good, keep the shiny side up, and we will check you guys out in the next video. Peace out.